Want to download and play Forge mods in your world? Well, that's what I'll show you in today's video. This video will show you how to download mods using the Forge mod loader. Chapters are provided in the video for you to navigate to the section you want. The first two steps is for those who want to download Forge for the Minecraft launcher. If you're using a mod launcher, which I suggest for playing modded, skip to this moment in the video as the first two chapters are not required. For those who just want to use the Minecraft launcher, proceed to the first step. For Forge mods, we'll need to download Forge. In your web browser, search for Minecraft Forge and click the link that takes you to minecraftforge.net. For most cases, you have the choice to select between downloading the latest or recommended Forge version. You can select which version of Minecraft you want to download Forge for on the left-hand side. I'll select the 1.20 version and click the installer file to download Forge. When you click, an ad wall will pop up. Don't click anything on this page. Just wait about 5 seconds before clicking the red skip button at the top right. This will download Forge, and now you can close this tab. Before we install, make sure to create and run your selected version of Minecraft once, and have it closed during the installation. For me, I'll create and run a 1.20 installation now, and close both the game and the launcher once it's done. With Forge downloaded, open the installer. If nothing happens, or if you recently installed Java, right-click the file and select Open with Java. A menu like this should pop up. You have the option to either install Forge for client, essentially single player, or server-side for multiplayer, or you can extract the file. For most cases, select the client, and after confirming your directory, press OK. Once Forge is installed, press OK and run Minecraft. Now, you should see a new installation profile of Forge for your chosen Minecraft version here. If not, select the drop-down menu and you should see it here. Now, go and run Minecraft with Forge once, and close it once you've loaded into the game. To download and install mods, skip to this section of the video now. If you're using a mod launcher, you can install Forge straight into your instance. For me, I'm going to use Prism, but you can use whichever mod launcher you want. Create a new instance by either clicking this button or right-clicking and select Create Instance. Select which version of Minecraft you want to use. I'm going to select 1.12.2. Now you have the option to select which mod loader you want. Since we're using Forge, select Forge here, and the version of Forge you want downloaded, and click OK. For those who don't have this available on their launcher, like with MultiMC, create your instance first. Now, go to your instance and select Edit Instance. You should now see an option to install Forge. Select the version of Forge you want to install, and click OK. Now, your instance has Forge installed. Now, we want to download a mod of our choosing. If you're not sure which mod you want to download, Modrinth, CurseForge, and Planet Minecraft offer a wide range of mods to choose from. For this video, I'm going to download the Dramatic Doors mod by Kites6660 on Modrinth. Make sure to read through the mod page to see if there's any mods that are required for this to run properly. With Dramatic Doors, there's no required mods, so we continue with the download process. You can view the featured versions of the mod on either the left or right hand side, or if you can't find the version you want, go to the Files or Versions tab and find it through there. Since I'm using 1.20, I'll download the version 2.3.5 of the mod. Make sure when you download the mod that the mod is for Forge, otherwise it won't work when you run the game. Once your mod is downloaded, we'll need to navigate to the Minecraft directory. For those using the Minecraft launcher, go to the Installations tab and click this folder icon over your chosen instance, which will direct you to the Minecraft directory. Now, go into the Mods folder. If you don't have a mods folder, create a folder and call it mods, or lowercase. Now, drag your chosen mod into the mods folder and run Minecraft. Do note that some mods can conflict with one another. If that's the case with you, you have to do some troubleshooting to determine which mod or mods are causing the conflict. To see if our mod is installed, we can either see it in the Mods tab or load into a world in Creative, and you should find it either in a separate category or amongst the default Creative tabs. If you're using a mod launcher like AT Launcher or Prism, you can download and install mods directly from the launcher into your current instance. To do this, go to the top right and select the Download Mods button. You can scroll through mods from Modrinth or CurseForge. For me, I'm going to download Zero's Minimap. Select your chosen mod for download. Read through the description of your mod to see if there's any mod dependencies. If so, select those to download as well and confirm the download. Now, you can run Minecraft and your mod should be there. Do note that some mods can conflict with one another. If that's the case with you, you have to do some troubleshooting to determine which mod or mods are causing the conflict. If your mod launcher doesn't have this feature, like Multi-MC, you must install them manually into your chosen instance. Fortunately, the process is quite simple. Once you have downloaded your chosen mod, navigate to your chosen Forge instance and click View Mods. You can either drag your downloaded mod straight in, or click the Add button to locate your downloaded mods. Run your instance, and they should be loaded in. That's how to download Forge and Forge mods. If those who want to use a different mod loader or want to get started in finding mods, check out these videos here.